broken down by sphere slots, and each one of these slots can contain texture that you can manipulate to include also specular levels, bumps, reflections, opacity levels, to your heart's content. But unfortunately, you'll see that we're only limited to a number of spheres in the material editor that it's broken down to. So how do we create an infinite amount of material slots that we can use? Well, to begin, we'll select our first slot here, and we'll change its name to Building Textures. And we'll change its standard mode to a multi-sub object. And we'll discard any old materials. And what this does is it makes a sub-dimension of material slots for us that we have an infinite amount that we can set. So now we have 10 here, and if we wanted to set this to a crazy number like 100, we can. We'll set this back down to something more like 10. Now to use these material slots, we'll go ahead and select the material name off to the right of material 1, for instance. And again, we're back to that first view when we selected the material slot 1 up here. And here we can set all the different maps that we need for this single material, such as diffuse, specular. It's pretty much the same as we were at our top level before we changed it to a multi-cell object. So let's start adding some materials to each one of our material slots now. So under the first one, we'll go into it again. And under the diffuse, we'll set up a new bitmap material. And it will allow us to choose the material that we want now. You know, over the years, I've collected pretty much every texture that I see and every texture that I get so that I can use it for instances such as this. So my texture library seems to be quite large. So what I like to do is I like to just fill up my multi-select object with just a bunch of materials that I find interesting or relate to this model or the plot or scene around it. Whether I'm going to use it or not, I just like to have my resources filled with a bunch of interesting textures that I can use at my will and not have to keep going out and finding things. So let's add, say, concrete underscore 20. Click it and choose open. And the first thing that I would like to do is change the name of this diffuse color. So we'll call it concrete number 20. And we'll go up a level. We'll also change this to concrete. Now the reason we did this is so that when we come back to our multi-select object, we have concrete number 20 as a unique name for material. So again, we'll just go down to material slot 2 and start filling this up. Click diffuse, bitmap, and we'll go out and find some more interesting textures. So jumping forward just a bit, you can see I've gotten filled up about 10 material slots with different materials such as concrete, wood, carpets, wallpapers, and floor tiles. So let's start assigning some of those materials to our actual model. We'll select our model, and typically the first thing I like to think about is what surfaces are the largest surfaces of our model, and in this instance, it's the outer walls of our building. So I like to go ahead and associate a texture with that particular surface and use that for the very first texture that we assigned the model. So let's take texture concrete 26, for instance. I think this is a great texture possibly for the outside of our walls and probably the majority of the large surfaces of our models. So I'll go into texture 26, and I want to make sure that I have show standard material in viewport turned on. And we're going to do this for all of our textures, but I tend to do it as I go through them and assign them. So I'll take texture 26 and I'll just drag it onto the model, and you'll see this texture shows up. We have some UV problems as far as the texture stretching on different surfaces. So let's just assign one large UVW map to this by going to our modifier list and adding a UVW map. And it's usually set to default as plane, so we're going to want to put that into a box so we get a nice even surface over all the faces. And you can go ahead and click the added UVW map to make sure that it's selected and change your transform. And we'll go ahead and just wallpaper that we've chosen for the bottom floor. So you might run into this a few times. I run into it still to this day, whereas I think this is a good idea at one part of texturing the model, and then I get down to another area where I think, okay, this is even better. And it becomes a pain to go back and select all the faces of the material that I want to replace, and then replace it with the material that I would like. And one quick way of actually reducing the amount of time in doing that is just go ahead and, with the polygon element selected, we'll go ahead and select a polygon of the material we want. And you'll see it highlights ID of 8. So if we say select all faces that have an ID of 8, it selects all the wood faces for us. We can go ahead and just replace that by hitting M for our material editor, and we'll just drag this new concrete texture onto it. Okay, and we can do the same for our two different wallpapers. So if we select one of the faces that has the wallpaper, we say, hey, it has an ID of 9. We'll select all the faces that have that same ID, and again, hit M to pull up the material editor, and we'll just drag our wallpaper 4 on it. Okay, and then we'll come in and do the same thing for this one. Select all faces that have an ID material of 7, and we will replace that with wallpaper 4. Great. So, because we went through level by level, this is the problem that you also run into when you want to replace one material with another one, is that the UVs are off. The top level has one resolution of UV, the middle has a different, and the bottom has another different one. So using that same trick, let's just select all faces that have an ID of 10, and we'll add a new UVW map. Okay. And we'll change our transform to a scale, and we'll just scale this down to a ratio, or an even ratio, from top, front, and left. Okay. And then we'll go ahead and just scale them all to bring in a tighter resolution. Maybe something like that. Go ahead and collapse this yet again. And that's our new consistent look across all the floors. Our first floor